Welcome to the second part of this cockpit virtual machines tutorial. Now we'll see a couple of preliminary steps for the setup. The first thing you need to do before working with cockpit is to install a network manager. If available on the system, cockpit uses network manager and the dbus API. So this is very important because if you don't do that, you cannot create the network bridge that is needed for the virtual machines to be on the same network as the host. The first step will be to configure your network using Network Manager and not, for example, on Debian, we have the networking.service, so we need to temporarily disable that and use Network Manager instead. Of course, to install Cockpit, each distro has its own packages, and for Debian in particular, we have Cockpit and Cockpit Machines. Then, if you are migrating virtual hard disks from another user, like I was when I migrated to Cockpit, I just added that user to the appropriate group, as it's explained here. And specifically, the user which was running qemu in my case now needs to be part of the libvirt qemu group. And also, you need to change the permissions to all the files and set them to this user and group. Okay, then we need to create for virtual machines a storage pool. A storage pool is practically a directory that the virtual machine component has access to it, and you can create two types of storage pools, the system and the user pool. The difference is that between the two is that the system storage pool is the one we're going to use because so it's like a more privileged storage. And if you see here, we have all the virtual machine images. So you need to create a system storage pool and avoid, of course, the user session pool. And of course, you need to set the full path containing the virtual machine hard disks. You need to decide where to put your files. And then we get to the interesting part because we need to configure the network. As I said, we need a network bridge. So it says here, open the networking tab. Okay, here I have all the Docker bridges. Then here I created my bridge, okay, my network bridge, which okay, in your case you will do, you click here on add bridge, then you have your physical network interface. In this example, I used the BR0 name. Check your Ethernet device, okay, you will do something like that, then save, and here you need to put BR0, okay. And then this step is important because if you have IP tables enabled, you need to forward the traffic to the bridge. Otherwise, all this setup is not going to work. So this is important. And so thank you for watching this part. See you soon for the next. Bye-bye.